the LMAX Exchange is attempting to be the eBay of the FX markets. We're trying to bring that democratization of the internet to what is seen as an opaque, complex financial world, which is FX. We've tried to do that. We have a very open exchange, just as Amazon or eBay, so that any buyer, any seller can transact on world-leading institutional prices. You're trying to disrupt the marketplace. The marketplace works in a certain way. So the first thing you have to do is explain that concept to people, explain to people who don't necessarily understand that way of transacting, and then spread the message. That message is through sales, through marketing, through distribution, through being on things like the TechTrack 100. So it's all about spreading the word, and then it's any exchange, just like you see in the wider market, again, back to the likes of eBay and Amazon, it is word of mouth, and flow begets flow. So more people know about you, they realize it's a better way to transact, and hopefully it becomes self-fulfilling. We're a catalyst for change. Hopefully we can accelerate change in the wider marketplace. We do that perhaps by using disruptive technology. So we harness world-leading technology. We harness the most modern technology. We're able to drive the cost down. And you know, what is pretty prominent now in the press is the requirement for transparency in the financial marketplace. We bring that. So if that disrupts what has been a pretty static marketplace, then so be it. I'm happy to be called a disruptor, but for now, we're happy to be a catalyst for change. If you want to be a disruptor in any market, I think you have to accept that you're going to be in the minority. Being in the minority is a good thing. If most people disagree with you, go with it, stick with it. After that, you need some other people, probably like-minded people within the company, who are happy that with the principles, and they're happy to be in that minority and stick to their beliefs. That's the hard thing, right? The persistence, sticking with it through thick and thin. If you know you're right, stay there. So like, if you like, be a bit stubborn and have the courage in your convictions. We take risks every day. It's just like trading. We must continue to take risk and get more of our decisions right than wrong. It's as simple as that. There are obviously financial risks. You know, personally, we did a management buyout a couple of years ago, so there's financial risk involved there. We've just opened an office in Hong Kong. That's a risk. We've just opened an exchange in Tokyo. That's a risk. We've hired 30 people, so we've increased the workforce by 25% in the last year. That's a risk. Most of our risks today have paid off. We'll continue to do that. That's the nature of business, it's the nature of financial markets. But I think it's important that we stretch ourselves if we want to fulfill our goals of being the number one in the marketplace. It's fantastic to be number one on the TechTrack 100 this year. I think more than anything, it's great recognition for all our stakeholders, from our staff to our clients to our shareholders and our partners in the industry.